I want to stay on this topic of the speech. And a short while ago, I spoke with musician, poet, and playwright and political activist Lowkey. I pointed out that he is just the type of person President Obama may want to reach. He's young, he's educated, and has a vested interest in what happens in the Arab world. So I asked him if he was being reached.
No, the president is not reaching me. And I really sincerely doubt he's reaching the people who are actually based within the places that he's talking about.
What would have to change? What would President Obama have to say to win you over or to at least get on board with, you know, some of his policies?
Well, I think, to be honest, one thing that he said which really struck me was he wanted the trade liberalization of Egypt. The question is, how much more liberal did he want the trade of Egypt to be? Under Hosni Mubarak, it was selling its natural gas to Israel for a third of its value. I mean, I don't know how much more liberal the trade could become. I think really he said something which I personally found to be quite a colonial choice of words. He said the entire region is facing a choice between hope and hate. I mean, this is really like a George Bush-ism, if ever there was one. I think that Mr. Obama clearly has a choice between empire and security. And that is not just security for the United States, that is security for all of its puppets around the world.
Well, let's stay on this topic of Egypt. I know a lot of people kind of getting ready, anticipating today's speech, compared it to the one we saw back in 2009 in Cairo. Certainly a lot has changed since then. But I want to play a portion of what President Obama said regarding Egypt, and then I'll get your take on it.
And that's why 2 years ago in Cairo, I began to broaden our engagement based upon mutual interests and mutual respect. I believed then, and I believe now, that we have a stake not just in the stability of nations, but in the self-determination of individuals. The status quo is not sustainable. Societies held together by fear and repression may offer the illusion of stability for a time, but they're built upon fault lines that will eventually tear asunder.
So here we have President Obama talking about, quote, societies held together by fear and repression. One thing that seems a little ironic, you know, I'll just throw it out there, is that he didn't mention Hosni Mubarak so much by name in terms of the fact that Hosni Mubarak, and you touched a little bit on this, was supported with money, with weapons, with support for the last couple decades. And now all of a sudden he's the person spreading fear.
Well, let's be completely clear and honest about this. I'm not one of those people who is a political cheerleader. The one thing which Egypt, Tunisia, Libya, and Syria, actually, up until 2004, all had in common is that they were complicit and they were involved. In fact, they were partaking in rendition for the United States. They were torturing terror suspects on behalf of the CIA. This is all four of these dictatorships were involved in that. All of these governments that they're talking about have capitulated to U.S. interests over the years. Some have capitulated less than others. This is why we have Libya and Syria being treated completely differently to, say, Yemen and Bahrain, for instance. You have in Yemen, with the collaboration of the Yemeni government, the United States have been droning that country over under Obama, which is something that Bush didn't do. Like I say, certain regimes have capitulated more than others, and this is why you have a difference in the way Obama is talking about. You know, in Bahrain, they've been killing people, and they have U.S. military base there. However, Mr. Obama said, started pointing the finger at Iran. Now, I don't mince my words when it comes to the Iranian government. Some people dislike me because of that, but I will tell you this, it is not the Iranian military that are based in Bahrain, it's the U.S. military and now the Saudi military as well.
Speaking of that,
also, Mr. Obama, you didn't hear a peep about the Saudis, even though he talked about rights of women and he talked about dictatorships. There are none more, more brutal than the Saudis. And also, he even had the nerve to talk about Iraqi democracy. Well, Iraq as a country holds the record for going the longest time after an election without forming a government. For over 10 months, there was no Iraqi government. They've just been banning trade unions in the electricity sector. Is this democracy? There's still over 50,000 US troops there and double as many contractors and mercenaries in this country. Is this democracy?
I know, Lowkey, one
of the... Is this the model of democracy?
One of the biggest frustrations for Obama supporters is that a lot of them are surprised at how President Obama is not quite as different a president as his predecessor. Now, RT spoke to author and filmmaker Tariq Ali about this point. I want to play this really quick and then get your thoughts.
In terms of that, Obama has been no different from Bush at all. I mean, the way he celebrated this cowboy behavior, sending in people into a compound in Pakistan to carry out a revenge killing, it had nothing to do with justice. It had everything to do with revenge.
So I know you mentioned, Lowkey, a little bit that there are sometimes similarities with President Bush and President Obama. Talk a little bit about this.
Well, I think definitely somebody whose opinion on this is very valuable is Mr. Donald Rumsfeld. He was being interviewed on Sky News, and he said one thing about Obama is that he was elected on the promise of being everything George Bush wasn't. That's what he campaigned on the basis of. He said, however, since Obama became the president, he has kept all of Bush's policies, whether it's the defense secretary, Robert Gates, or anything else. But me personally, I would disagree with Mr. Rumsfeld and say he's extended further than George Bush has. Guantanamo Bay is still open. George Bush did bomb Pakistan, but not to the extent that Obama has done. George Bush did not bomb Yemen. Obama has bombed Yemen. George Bush did not bomb Libya. Obama has bombed Libya. You know, this is an extension of the George Bush policy, in my view.
That was Lowkey, musician, poet, playwright, and political activist.